Good morning to all of you. In this class, I am going to start with another important topic of chapter, molecular basis of inheritance. And the topic is initiating factors in protein synthesis. Protein synthesis. We were discussing about the protein synthesis process. In the protein synthesis, the different initiating tRNA, initiating amino acid, initiating codons, or initiating codons. Then how the initiation takes place, or what are the Kozak sequence, or what are the sequences, or what are the Shine-Dahl-Gardner sequence? We discussed in previous class. So in this class, I am going to discuss about the initiating factors. Initiating factors. There are three types of initiating factors which take part in the protein synthesis process, or they have the significant role in the protein synthesis process, or they also initiate, because in the absence of these factors, the protein synthesis cannot be initiated. Like the tRNA, initiating tRNA is also important, and initiating amino acid, initiating codons are also important, and so that the Shine-Dahl-Gardner sequence and Kozak sequence are important too. So when we discuss about Shine-Dahl-Gardner sequence, that is a specific that have a specific sequence by which they easily recognized by the ribosome, a small subunit of ribosome, so that tRNA can easily bind at A site at the ribosome. Because of the A site, the ribosome consists of three sites: A site, P site, and E site. E site is amino acid binding site, tRNA binding site. Peptidyl site is peptidyl tRNA site. Then E site is exit site. So by these reasons, they actually initiate the protein synthesis process. So the initiating factor is important because they inhibit the reunion or association of premature association of large subunit and small subunit in prokaryotes as well as in eukaryotes too. So the initiation factors are IF1, IF2, IF3. Initiation factor 1, initiation factor 2, and initiation factor 3. Now, what is the function of initiation factor 1? Initiation factor 1 bind with a small subunit of ribosome, bind over E site of a small subunit of ribosome, a small subunit of ribosomes, so that they prevent the premature association of initiator tRNA. So when the initiation factor 2 release from the A site, finally A site open for the binding with tRNA, initiator tRNA, or finally the initiator tRNA bind at A site to form the first, to add the first amino acid in the protein synthesis process. So the initiation factor first cover the A site of a small subunit of ribosome, that is 30S subunit of ribosome, so that they can prevent tRNA, or also said to be initiating tRNA, prevent tRNA for at actually prevent tRNA before the binding of if here is prokaryotes, then before binding of 50S subunit. So that actually they prevent the tRNA for premature association of tRNA at the 30S subunit. Subunit of ribosome. Now, initiation factor 2. Initiation factor 2 because initiation factor 2 have the GTPase activity, so that the initiation factors have a 2. The initiation factors 2 mainly they hydrolyze the GTP and use energy for transfer of amino acyl tRNA at the site of 30S subunit, so that they can bind with these region. So with the help of initiation factor 2, because they have GTPase activity, so that easily they can bind with the 30S subunit, or they also help in the transfer of this charged tRNA, or also said to be amino acyl tRNA at the region of this 30S subunit or A site of 30S subunit. So initiation factor 2 bind with amino acyl tRNA, because they have tRNA to provide energy for transmission, energy for transmission of these amino acid tRNA, because they have the GTPase activity. Because IF2 have GTPase activity. So due to this reason, the IF2 can bind with the initiation with the tRNA, and by the use of GTP or GTP hydrolysis, the energy provided by the GTP molecule or GTP components, so that the tRNA have energy for transfer to the at the region of 30S subunit of A site of 30S subunit. So and because of this could be done with the help of IF2, because they have the GTPase activity, or they bind with tRNA to provide the energy for transferring of the amino acid. So initiation factor involved, that initiation factor involved only in the transfer of initiator tRNA. Not all type of tRNA that the tRNA that proceed the chain of protein or that elongate the chain of protein. So the factors which involve in the elongation or which involve in the transferring of tRNA during elongation process, so that factor is known as elongation factor. Or in the termination, those factors which involve in the termination of protein synthesis, that these type of factor are known as releasing factor. But in the initiation step of protein synthesis, the initiator factors used for the protein synthesis, initiation factor 1 involve and bind over the A site of the small subunit, so that they bind or cover the A site of small subunit, or they prevent the tRNA prevent the tRNA for binding to the 30S subunit. So, but IF2, they bind with tRNA, they bind with initiating tRNA, and they provide energy for transmission of amino acid at the region of ribosome or at the region of 30S subunit. Or they also help in providing or use the ATPase enzyme or ATPase hydrolysis or have the ATPase activity, or by which they utilize the energy source from GTP for that energy utilized during the transmission of these amino acid or amino acid tRNA at the site of initiation, at the initiation site or at the initiation codon, so that first amino acid can be easily coded at the region of AUG. So now the initiation factor third. Initiation factor third involved in preventing the pre-association of immature 30S subunit and 50S subunit. So what is the meaning of these? They prevent the binding of 30S subunit with the 50S unit. So before the attachment of 30S subunit at the region of AUG sequence, or also said to be COSAC sequence, they are not able to bind with 50S subunit. So that they prevent the binding of 50S subunit. That is known as premature association of 50S or 30S subunit. So they prevent IF2 bind with 30S subunit like IF1, but IF first initiation factor bind over small subunit at the site of A, and these bind with a small subunit at the site of P, or also at the site of in between the E or P, so that they prevent the reassociation of 50S or 30S subunit. Now they bind with 30S subunit. 30S subunit of 30S subunit of ribosome, prevent pre-association of 30S and 50S. Now all these are the function of only 1, 2 and 3's initiation, 3's initiation factor involved in initiating the process of protein synthesis. All these factors, initiation factor with initiating tRNA, with initiating amino acid, with initiating codons, together help in the formation of proteins in the initiate help in the initiation of protein synthesis. Now after this, all these come together for the protein synthesis in the initiation step. So let us discuss about the initiation step, or how the initiator protein, initiator tRNA, initiator protein, initiator codons, or COSAC sequence, or Shine-Dalgarno sequence, initiator tRNA, how initiator codons work too. So first we discuss about the initiation, elongation and termination. Now here we have already discussed about the components of initiation, initiation factor, codon, amino acid. Now this is the time to discuss about the process of initiation, because we have already discussed about the all the components which are used in initiation step. So initiation step, first the here is mRNA sequence which have because we are going to discuss about the prokaryotes or eubacteria initiation because it is quite easy than the eukaryotes or so many initiation or the initiation factors which we have discussed like previous that initiation factor actually involved in the eukaryotic translation or the initiation but the more than three factors in initiation factors involved in that is approximately 12 initiation factors involved in the eukaryotic initiation. So that is quite easy the eukaryote discussion of the protein synthesis in eukaryotes is easier than the prokaryotes prokaryotes is easier than the eukaryotes in bacteria actually. Now here is the strand of mRNA single stranded 5 prime 3 prime. Now the ribosome small subunit can bind with the recognize the Shine-Dalgarno sequence which is present at the region of 5 prime end or upstream of the towards the upstream of the mRNA so that they can easily recognize the Shine-Dalgarno sequence. Then they move along after the Shine-Dalgarno sequence. Finally, after 3 to 10 nucleotides. COSAC sequence is present. Here is COSAC sequence is present. COSAC sequence, which is formed by which is surrounded by the specific sequence that surround the initiation codon. So this is also a specific sequence that surround the initiation codon. Between the COSAC sequence, the initiation codons are present AUG, and here is the another codons ACC. This one is ACC and AUGG. So here is the specific sequence that is surrounded by the COSAC sequence. The AUG only the initiation codon. So other than AUG, some of the GUG or UUG are also present that initiate the protein synthesis in the eubacteria. So here is the initiation in eubacteria. It's bacteria or also said to be prokaryotes. Now the ribosome first bind with the Shine-Dalgarno sequence, the small subunit, or then they move along the chain in the direction of downstream or towards the 3 prime end of the mRNA. Now what they need, the 30S subunit with initiation factor 1 or initiation factor 2 bind at the region of Shine-Dalgarno sequence and move along the chain or find the COSAC sequence. That COSAC sequence surround the initiation codon AUG. Now when they find the COSAC sequence, they also find the initiation codon or at this region. Finally, the 30S subunit bind with the help of initiation factor 1 or initiation factor 2. Initiation factor present at the region of or here is a small subunit of ribosome. This region is A site, as we already discussed in previous class. this region is A site. Towards the A site, the initiation factor. Here is initiation factor 3, not 2. Initiation factor 3. Initiation factor 1 bind at the A site and just previous or just before the P site or IF 3 factor, initiation factor 3 bind. And here is the P site which is open for the binding of initiating tRNA. So initiating tRNA bind at the P site, at the region of P site, because the also said to be before the P site, that is covered, and IF1 present cover over the A site so that they prevent the binding of initiating tRNA at the A site. They allow the initiating tRNA bind on the P site. So that's why the region is open for binding of the initiating tRNA, or that can be easily recognized by initiating tRNA, because initiation factor 1 prevent binding of initiating tRNA at the A site. Now initiation factor 3 prevent the binding of association of premature ribosome, last subunit of ribosome. So they do not allow the binding of last subunit of ribosome. So when they bind, that region then moving along the chain, and finally they recognize the all together. They recognize the this initiation complex recognize the initiation codon present in between the COSAC sequences, or in that is surrounded by the ACC and G. So and after this, finally here is the mRNA. Now 5 prime end, 3 prime end, at the COSAC region A, U, G. Or they attach at this attach at initiation codon in such a manner so that the codons present at or near the P site, so that when the tRNA with anticodon bind with the codons, so they also present at the P site. When the last subunit added to this region or to the 30S subunit or small subunit, that catalyze the bond formation of peptide bond formation, or due to which the peptide bond formation occur at the region. So they associate the 30S subunit with initiation factor 1 and 3 associate at the region of initiation codon in such a manner that AUG present or comes over the peptidyl site, so that when the initiating tRNA bind at the AUG codon with their anticodon, they also present at the peptidyl site, and when they cover with when the last subunit bind with 30S subunit, the peptidyl, because all the sites overlap each other, peptidyl site A site, so that when the last subunit bind, they also have the peptidyl activity or also have the peptide bond formation activity. So that catalyze the reaction or in between the two amino acid, and finally the bond formation occur in between the two amino acid with the help of last subunit. So here is P site, this one, and here is A site. And finally, after or the initiation factor 1, initiation factor 3, and here is initiation factor, because here is A site, also initiation factor bind at this region IF1, initiation factor. Now initiation factor, when the last subunit after the association of this, or after the association of 30S subunit IF1 or IF3, finally the tRNA with JTP activity or IF2 factor comes at the region of P site or bind with codons, with their anticodons. Now, I make it above how the tRNA Now, here is the initiation factor 2 with tRNA, because I am talking about the eubacteria. So the tRNA have the amino acid. tRNA have amino acid methionine. For F, methionine tRNA. So formyl methionine tRNA with initiation factor 2. Initiation factor 2 and GTP activity also. Because IF2 have the GTPase activity that utilize the GTP or undergoes in hydrolysis to release the 2-phosphate group in the form of GDP, or IF2 that provide energy or through which IF2 initiation factor to the tRNA easily transfer at the region of initiation codon, or also they help in the association of anticodon with codon. So when they come at the region of, here is 5', 3', this is similar codons AUG at P region, at P site. Here is A site. Now the tRNA with methionine with anticodon here is 5' and 3', 3' hydroxyl group, 3', 5', or at the 3' region the formyl methionine bind at the 3' region amino acid, or here is a D loop help in the association with the initiation factor to IF2, or they bind IF2 or with the GTP activities also. The GTP activities, I make it here, GTP have with the help of GTP, or they, the GTP hydrolysis takes place in the presence of initiation factor, or they bind with initiation codon with the help of anticodon present at the region of A bind with U. The anticodons are U bind with A, G bind with C. So anticodon present at the initiating tRNA are UAC. And because we already know adenine always form double hydrogen bond with uracil, and here is adenine also again form double hydrogen bond with uracil, and cytosine form triple hydrogen bond with guanine. So the double and triple hydrogen bond formation takes place in between the these two region. After the binding of these, the initiation factor 1, 2, 3. Initiation factor 3 and GDP, guanosine diphosphate, releases out so that association of last subunit takes place at this region. So here is all these together release, or after the release of initiation factor 3 or initiation factor 1 and 2, finally the last subunit bind at the region of this initiation. Here is AUG, P site. Now A site is free for the binding of elongation tRNA, and here is last subunit. Last subunit is larger than the small subunit, but here is no place for making or draw it, so here now, here is P site again, tRNA bind with anticodon or formyl methionine amino acid. And here is A site is free for binding of tRNA, elongation tRNA. So, here is the overall initiation. Now, initiation in with the binding of last subunit or the 50S subunit. 50S subunit here is 30S subunit or tRNA with anticodon UAC bind with the double or with the help of double or triple hydrogen bond at the region of T site, and finally the A site is open or open because all the initiation factor 1, initiation factor 2, initiation factor 3 are releases, and that due to the release of initiation factor 3, because they prevent the initiation factor 3 only prevent the association of large and small subunit. When the initiation factor releases out, the large subunit interact with T sub or small subunit, or finally they bind with the small subunit or 2 for elongation process. So elongation process started after the addition of large subunit. So here is the overall initiation of the protein synthesis. In next class we are going to discuss we will discuss about the elongation process. So I hope you like this video, so keep listening and watching me. Thank you for listening and watching me.